Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to upgrade my HGLRC Draknight and I am going to install this camera, the new OpenIPC Thinker all-in-one Tiny. Okay, so I have already opened the box. This box includes all the wires you will need to install the camera. And I have used this antenna from the EMAX Wyvern Link 100 milliwatts because in the box it was this antenna. So this antenna is quite big, so it will not fit in this toothpick. What I also did is I replaced the camera lens, because if you can see, it's quite big, the lens that comes with the Thinker Tiny. The lens is much smaller and it will fit in this frame. Well, this camera will not fit. It comes with 20 by 20 holes, but it has also a heatsink that enables it to use with a toothpick. It has these sockets. This socket is for external Wi-Fi. This socket is for connected to the laptop and do some settings or update the camera. This socket is to connect it with the flight controller. I have already soldered the cables, the required cables, which is the UART, the TX and RX, and the power and ground. So four wires only are required. While it comes with six wires, we don't need all six. And then very gently, very carefully, you need to connect this plug and make sure to not bend any pins. They're very, very delicate, like so. Okay, so now that we have it connected, I think I will put the heatsink underneath, like so. Also, I used a standoff, plastic standoff here, because if you can see, it's the Express LRS antenna here, and I don't want the heatsink of the Thinker damage the antenna. And that's why I had to use some standoffs on all four ends. And you can see it can fit directly. And I'm gonna use this tiny screw to secure it. And also I know that the upper plate, the top part of the frame, will hold it firmly down. And I had to pass the antenna through this hole and then of course connect it and secure it. So you see it's very straightforward, the whole build. I'm going to screw the camera on the frame. Okay. So that's it basically. Now we need to make the wires a little bit tidy. And then put the screws to make the frame as it was. It's quite a nice frame, this one. And there are a lot of similar frames nowadays in the market. So you can basically use these frames instead. And I think the drone is ready. Yeah, it looks really nice. And now we're going to put the propellers that goes to the back. Something like this. And then the battery will fit under the quad, like so. Okay, let's wait. The OpenIPC Thinker Tiny has also this cable and this Ethernet adapter if you want to use, or you can use it directly like that. I'm gonna use it like this though, because I want an extension to reach on the laptop. And as I told you earlier, there is a plug here for this specific cable. Make sure to put it the right way to not bend the tiny pins, which are very, very delicate. Okay. And now we can connect our drone to the configurator so we can update the firmware. And always use a fan while working on the bench. Make sure to use the latest OpenIPC configurator, and you want to have green light here. Then you go to setup, you select OpenIPC Thinker All-in-One NOR, and you click update camera. At this state, you should not touch anything on the computer, except if it asks you to press enter, you need to press return to begin session. I have already flashed SBC 199 version on my EMAX VRX. Okay, so now it has done the unconditional reboot. And all we need to do is press any key, and then we can connect. As you can see, we receive some file, and then it asks us to press return to begin session, and it closes. Now we open it again, we click connect. And you can see that all the settings have been loaded. And all we need to do is change channel to channel 60. Change the TX power. I'm going to use 30 TX power. I've been told that it is safe to use on the Thinker. Bandwidth 40, MCS 3. Then we go to camera, we select 60 frames per second, and the bit rate 24 megabits per second, and we click save and reboot. We connect, return. And we want to change the MTU. I have posted a video about the jumbo packets. Please go and watch it. It's very interesting and explains what are the jumbo packets. And we click this button. Not save and reboot, this button. And I believe that if we power on, our EMAX VRX, and as you can see, it is working, and suddenly I have mounted the camera upside down. Hello there. Everything is working, the OSD is working, and we have 25 megabits per second video bitrate. Okay, I have changed the orientation of the camera. I have it correct now. And what we need to do is go to telemetry and hit the MSP OSD Air Extra. And this button will add some extra OSD data that will show us the actual video bitrate, the temperature, the CPU load, and the frames per second. Okay, let's press it. Return, and that's it. It will reboot. And after the reboot, you will have the video bitrate, the temperature, the CPU, and the frames per second. Right, everything is ready. Let's go out and fly it.